Time you get your car insurance bill, you might notice a difference in the price.
It's because of a proposed state regulation, but will it cause your premiums to go up or down?
That is the big question. New this morning, Chris Mavadis has been looking into this, joins us from the studio. Chris, what'd you find out?
Hey there, Pat. Well, that regulation, if it gets implemented, would ban car insurance companies from using your education history and job status as factors to set your rates. It's a practice Governor Andrew Cuomo called discriminatory.
I don't think it's a good thing. It's another form of discrimination.
Marge Bergeson agrees with the governor. Now, after a State Department of Financial Services investigation, a proposed regulation could ban that practice in New York. The DFS superintendent said that would be the case unless insurance companies can clearly demonstrate a plausible relationship to the risk of loss. Brian Link can see how that could be the case.
If you're in that age range and uneducated, as far as people might say, based on college versus non-college, you're quite likely to get, you're more likely to get in an accident than someone who's not in that category.
Back in November, the Wall Street Journal reported that the state reached out to Allstate, Geico, Liberty Mutual, and Progressive to ask why this shouldn't be banned. The paper noted unskilled workers sometimes pay higher premiums. Now officials are moving ahead with this proposed regulation, currently under a 45-day public comment period. And even if Lane can understand why insurance companies do it,
I don't necessarily think it makes it right that they're doing it. I wouldn't say it's fair to people, because there's plenty of people who are going to get lumped into that category being, perhaps at risk, and therefore they have to pay more.
And at the same time, insurance companies are warning this regulation could have the reverse effect and could result in you paying more. Property Casualty Insurers Association of America is a trade group that represents insurers. Vice President Thayer told us insurers use factors such as education and occupation because they are helpful in predicting the likelihood of an insurance loss and allow for more accurate underwriting and pricing. She also said insurers have been trying to prove that to the state for years now. If this regulation is implemented after the public comment period, insurance companies would have 6 months to get in line. Nikki?
Thank you, Chris. Just